Good afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni and
Amory Gianni
from the Renegade Health Show, and today is Friday, and today we have a very special location for today's show. We're going to answer some questions, but there's a pretty special location here, so let me show you this side first. We have the Puget Sound and the Olympic Mountains over there, and then we have some big cruise ships here, big ferries, and then we have the Seattle skyline. How cool is that? We came to Seattle. We're impressed with how clean it is. What do you think, Henry?
It's gorgeous.
Yeah, it's really nice, really clean. You know, we're from New York. New York is fairly clean nowadays. I don't know if it used to be, but, you know, the subways used to have graffiti all over them and all that sort of stuff. But anyway, today what we're going to do is Henry's squinting. Henry does not have an eye problem. She just has a squint issue. What, you're done, huh? And Henry is having trouble with the sun. All right, what we're going to do while we're out here enjoying the day is we are going to answer some of your questions, and then we're going to wish you a happy weekend. And that's pretty much what we're going to do today. So first off, Jean asked, Kevin, I don't even think you read the comments. She's got a great recipe for beet kvass, K-V-A-S-S. Jean, I don't know what that is, but if you have a great recipe for it, please post it. We'd love to know, and we are reading your comments. Know that, everyone. We do read the comments, always. Eva asks, or actually says that she's been eating a raw diet, but her legs cramp at night. Eva, here's what you need to do. You need to get a mineral test. Chances are you're low in minerals, probably magnesium, calcium, maybe even potassium. Go get a mineral test and get that taken care of right away. What that means most likely is that you have an acidic condition in your body. So we want to get you some minerals right away. Take a blood test, see what's missing, and then let's really load it up with some green juice and some minerals and a whole bunch of good stuff. Lori says, what do you suggest for a friend who is in the hospital and possibly has cancer? You know, obviously I recommend that someone go to a health practitioner. And what I also recommend is that you get her the book, Charlotte Gerson's book, and just give it to her or him or her, and use that as an educational tool that they can read and kind of get their own opinion. You're not going to force anyone to do anything, but you can give them a tool. And if you give them the Gerson book, maybe they will be excited about it, maybe they won't, but it is definitely a tool. Let's see who else. Nadia asks if you can put probiotics directly into cabbage to actually help it ferment and make a sauerkraut. And absolutely you can. You can just crack open your little, I have my little notes here. You can crack open your little probiotic pill and put it into the cabbage or anything that you're fermenting to give it a really good boost of good bacteria. But also remember is that a lot of probiotics are not very strong, so you want to find a very good probiotic. I will tell you right now, we've been using John Barron's probiotic, but we're actually creating our own. And we're creating our own because we're really excited because it is super powerful. I mean, 50 billion microorganisms at the time of manufacture. You can't find that anywhere. Very powerful probiotic because I think it's so important to have a good one. And I'm tired of guessing when I go to the health food store. Aaron asks, you know, what's the truth about raw greens? You know, because you listened to Donna Gates' call on Wednesday, and Donna was talking, you know, if you eat your raw greens, like your cruciferous vegetables, it might actually cause thyroid issues. Here's the deal. I've heard both. I've heard the back and forth. And so what I want people to do is, really, I want them to be continually testing their thyroid to see if leafy green vegetables happen to be an issue with their thyroid condition. So if you're eating leafy green vegetables and the goitrogens, which is the compound that does affect your thyroid, if that's showing that, you know, your thyroid levels are decreasing and your thyroid is becoming compromised, then yeah, you know, cut back on the leafy green vegetables. If you're eating leafy green vegetables and nothing's happening, then you're fine. So I really want to make sure that we become our own health experts and become our own advocates and really our own knowledge base for this information. You need to be your own Google when it comes to health. You need to be able to search yourself for the answers. All right, so your question of the day is this. What is your favorite resource for cancer? Go ahead and post it down below. Let's get a little, let's get a whole big database going here from your comments. Your best resource for cancer, which you feel is a really good, valuable bit of information for maybe Lori. Is it Lori? Yes, for Lori's friend. All right, this is Kevin Gianni and
Anne-Marie.
And I'm sweating like crazy. It's so hot here. Together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time. Have a great weekend.